I would like to mention that this corporation, the Northeast Handicrafts and Handloom Development Corporation, was established in 31st March in the year 1977 with its registered office at Shillong, Meghalaya, with the basic mandate of promotion and development of handicrafts and handlooms of the Northeastern region. So this mandate was in fact commenced with imparting training during the initial years of inception of the corporation in various parts of Northeast, thereafter by sourcing and procuring their goods and by selling the goods on their behalf through Emporia, through various exhibitions, craft fairs, expos, etc. So far as capacity building is concerned, capacity building has to take place in its totality. It should have both the vertical and horizontal linkages. Under capacity building, the corporation has been instrumental in providing the needed training and skill upgradation. Number two, identifying the right tools and appliances for the artisans, which they can use efficiently for production of better quality products. Number three, R&D activities in case of, especially in case of handlooms, we have lots of ethnic designs and patterns which can really be taken out and produced in bulk for marketing. Then orientation programs, seminars and workshops to energize and to make them aware as to why these products need to be upgraded so that there is a market, as you have to face a market competition. This needs to be percolated down to the cluster level, to the artisans and weavers. And with this mandate, NEHHDC has been instrumental towards the end of it in design intervention, because design is the prime characteristic that a product will convey. A product can be made in several ways. The design comes from the beholder's point of view. If a person likes the design, the particular item gets sold and the artisan gets benefited. Therefore, design intervention has been a constant effort that the corporation has been undertaking since its inception in the year 1977. Every year, the corporation has been undertaking design intervention projects in some form or other, so that we can come out at least 50 to 60 new designs every year, and we can commercialize them in the market, and artisans and weavers can be benefited directly, and some artisans indirectly who work under master craftsmen or master weavers. NEHHDC, in order to reach out to the market, has set up Emporia and regional sales promotion offices elsewhere in the country. As of now, we have 10 such Emporia and regional sales promotion offices located at Shillong, Guwahati, Kolkata, New Delhi, Bangalore and Chennai. So most of the products which are sourced and procured from the artisans and weavers at cluster level are dispatched to these destinations for making them available to the buyers in those parts of the country. Another option is that NEHHDC organizes a large number of events, namely marketing events, under the banner of exhibitions, craft bazaar, trade expos and so on, where the artisans and weavers are also invited to participate to showcase their products and directly sell to the consumers. Third option is that NEHHDC has launched two web portal. In fact, one is exclusively for online marketing, www.nehhdc.in, where these products are on display and products can also be sourced online. Fourth option is that the institutional buyers, the corporate houses or other departments, can directly place the requirement with us and we can cater to their requirements. Second point is that we have a big showroom cum warehouse set up at Guwahati, where all the products that are sourced and procured from various parts of the Northeastern region are kept, and from there we dispatch to various destinations either to meet the requirement of Emporia, regional sales promotion offices, exhibitions and institutional requirements. Yeah, I would like to mention here that the artisans and weavers in the Northeastern region are traditionally involved in crafting, weaving, designing on their own, and they have never been actually marketing their products, and they really do not know how to market their products. So the mandate of NEHHDC has been that we take them, provide a hand-holding support so that they can market their products. Now, one step towards this is that we invite the artisans and weavers to participate in various marketing events that we organize every year. And there, our sales staff or our sales promotion officers, they provide them the helping hand as to how to fix the prices, how to negotiate with the buyers, how to record or book the orders, and various other aspects of real marketing. So they are provided training on the spot during exhibitions. Another option is that we provide some slots or built-up spaces in the emporium where the artisans and weavers display their products in our emporium for marketing. So the emporium managers and other officers in the emporium, they provide the know-how as to how to market, how to interact with the buyers who visit, how to tell a story about the product, and how to price suitably, about the quality norms, everything. So that is the second step that we follow in order to educate them on the areas of marketing. In other words, we also organize some training programs as well as awareness programs, seminars in various towns and clusters in the Northeastern region and even other parts of the country, where we invite selected artisans and weavers and explain them on various aspects, not only on marketing, on quality aspects, on design aspects, and costing is very important, on e-marketing and other such related issues, which ultimately help them to market as an efficient marketing personnel. See, this is a very difficult area to handle because we also often come across such a situation where fake material is being sold in the market. Some people sell silk as pure silk, but it is not pure silk, it is blended with polyester or other synthetic yarn. First step towards this is that we have to educate the people, especially the artisans and weavers or the producers, the importers, the exporters, whomsoever we come across. We tell them very clearly that our mandate is to really market the genuine products of Northeastern region, not the fake ones. And one should be very transparent and clear not to indulge in such practices. And we tell them specially that whenever a product is made, if it is made from pure silk, for example, it should be declared as pure silk. If it has been blended also, there is no harm in blending and mixing, but it has to be declared to the customer that it has been blended with other yarn, and it will be priced accordingly. Therefore, there should not be, nothing is to be hidden, everything should be made transparent, because we cannot work at the cost of artisans and weavers and on their livelihood. So whatever we do, we should be very clear and transparent in the deals. We are not able to directly tackle this mania because there are several producer groups, several artisans and weavers involved. Lots of people may be indulging in such practices. But so far as we are concerned, we are very clear to this this sector that whatever we produce, whatever you get produced from the artisans and weavers, whatever you sell, they are the genuine products made from natural fiber or man-made fiber, and the genuine products go to the right customers to meet their ultimate satisfaction. Since the basic mandate of the corporation is to promote handicrafts and handlooms, the first step, the first mandate would be to see that the corporation continues to source and procure the handicrafts and handloom products from the artisans and weavers spread over the entire Northeastern region, and then try to market them. In order to do so, since we have 10 smaller or bigger emporia and regional salesperson offices, we have planned this year, 17-18, to have at least 100 plus retail exhibitions throughout the country, including one or two abroad, where we propose to invite at least 50 to 60 artisans per event and provide them the marketing. Number two, we also want to take up marketing in a bigger way through online portal. We already have a portal, as I have told you earlier. We would like to upload more and more products so that we have more customer base. We also have launched a Facebook page. We will be soon launching a WhatsApp page. We want to reach out to the customers as well as to the artisans and weavers and link them to the various segments in the economy who can really consume the products of Northeast handicrafts and handlooms. One aspect is very important, that in our showrooms, if you have visited, you will see that we are lacking in the merchandising aspect of it. We really do not know as to how to display the products to draw attention of the visitors. Therefore, we have decided to appoint 4 visual merchandisers for a period of initially 1 year to ensure that the showrooms really display the products in a very thematic manner so that the buyers and visitors are attracted. That is also one way that we have thought on. We have also proposed to visit the entire Northeastern region once again, organize seminars and workshops, organize skill development training programs, skill upgradation programs, and design interventions, so that we can not only develop the skills of the artisans and weavers, we can also come out with better, innovative, and value-added products.